That's the reason I request you to join a bit early, right? You should come early to the class. Yeah? Should not be like your regular class. You will always come late. Yeah? Okay, so we'll start with where we. So last class we discussed about the laminar flow, and I'll bring back that same slide once again to just have a continuity. We saw that when the flow encounters a solid surface, a laminar boundary develops around the surface. Okay, so this boundary layer thickness varies from a leading edge. Leading edge means where it the edge faces the flow. So from here to the trailing edge, the boundary layer thickness varies. Okay, so this thickness goes on increasing. For this, the equations are available. They are available in data and book. I showed you where they are available, how to use them. We solved a problem to determine the boundary layer thickness and also the shear stress and the shear force that acts on the surface, because the flowing fluid will drag the surface. So what is the drag force? That can be calculated. That has nothing to do with heat transfer. Okay, so that is different. That is fluid dynamics. Whenever fluid interacts with surface, it exerts a shear force on the surface. How to calculate that shear force and shear stress that we take? Okay, so in this this is all about a laminar flow and a laminar boundary layer. But flows are not always laminar. It can be a turbulent also, right? The flow can be turbulent. Initially it can be laminar, later it will transition into a turbulent flow. We have seen that how to classify a laminar and turbulent flow. I said that the Reynolds number, which is REX, if it is in excess of 5 lakhs, then the flow is characterized as a turbulent flow. As long as the Reynolds number is within 5 lakhs, the flow is considered to be a laminar flow. This we have discussed. Okay. So when the flow is laminar, how to calculate the thickness, modular thickness that we saw, and how to calculate from that heat transfer coefficient we have seen in the earlier class. Basically, we determine the Nusselt number, and from Nusselt number we calculate the heat transfer coefficient. Okay. So now let us see if the flow is turbulent, how to address such problems, how to solve those problems. Okay. So that we'll discuss in this class. So as I said, in a laminar boundary layer, there will be a boundary layer, and the heat transfer coefficient will vary. It decreases from a leading edge to the trailing edge. This we have seen in the last class. So, and also we have seen the equations for the boundary layer thickness and the boundary layer the shear stress at the boundary layer at the surface. So the equation for the boundary layer thickness, as we saw in the data handbook, it's available. This equation is available in the data handbook. Okay. So if I see this equation, the boundary layer is a function of the distance x for a given flow velocity. Okay. And the fluid, the boundary layer delta x is a function of x. As x increases, you can see in this graph, as x increases, the delta x increases. Okay, boundary layer thickness, hydrodynamic boundary layer thickness increases. Okay, delta hx. So if you see here, what is the relation? Just we'll see the boundary layer. If you from this equation we find that the boundary layer is a function of a boundary layer is directly proportional to the square root of x, because we have seen this Reynolds number REX is directly proportional to the x. Okay, so therefore the thickness is proportional to the square root of x. So whereas the rate of growth, the rate at which the boundary layer increases, is the is proportional to 1 divided by square root of x. Okay, so all this we have seen in the last class. Okay, so then comes the shear stress at the surface. So for this also we have an equation. You can see the shear stress decreases from leading edge to the trailing edge. So here the shear stress is proportional to 1 divided by square root of x distance. Okay, so as the boundary layer grows, the shear wall stress decreases. Okay, this is what we discussed. Once again, relook at what we discussed in the last class. Okay, so now let us go for turbulent boundary layer. So what is a turbulent boundary layer? The initially, as we said, a flow will be laminar and then a turbulent. Not necessary. Sometimes it can be turbulent right from the beginning. Right, the turbulence can start right at the leading edge. If velocities are very high, then the turbulence can begin right at the leading edge. Okay, so if you see here, so we said that how to classify, that the classification is based on the Reynolds number. Okay, so a critical parameter is, as long as Reynolds number is within 5 lakhs, the flow is considered to be laminar. When the Reynolds number is more than 5 lakh, it is a turbulence that we have seen. So in the turbulent region, how to find out this the transfer coefficient? So for that, this turbulent boundary layer equations are similar to the laminar ones, but difficult to solve. So these are normally not analytically solved. So the equations that you saw for laminar flow, they are analytically solved. Solution is available in many books. Okay, you can refer to heat transfer by J.P. Holman. For the turbulent flow, the solutions are very difficult to find out. So usually correlations based on the experimental data are used here. Okay, so that is empirical equations are used. Okay, for a turbulent region, the equations for the drag coefficient or friction coefficient is 0.059 into Re to the power -2. Okay, this is available in a data handbook. Okay, so these relations are available in a data handbook in page number 130. Okay, so if you go here, the equation for, okay, sorry, not 130, 130. So for, so here the friction coefficient and all the equations for the turbulent flow are available. So if you can see here, turbulent flow for a flat flow, this is a page number 113. So for a boundary layer thickness, okay, the equation is available. Similarly for the CFX, also it is available. This is for, these equations are, this is 1.4, 1.41 are the equations when the flow is turbulent right from beginning, from the leading edge. If the flow is turbulent, then this equation is used. If the flow is not turbulent right from beginning, then a different set of equations are used. Okay, so let's see. If the flow is, suppose you want to consider the, let's say the flow is laminar and then turbulent, then this equation has to be used for the heterodynamic boundary layer thickness, delta H. To find out delta H, we have to use this equation, not the above equation. Above equation, you will just go back. See, here the delta X equation is available, which is delta HX is equal to 0.381X into RE to the power -0.2, right? This equation is valid if the flow is turbulent right from the leading edge. Okay, there is no laminar flow. Flow is totally turbulent right from the beginning. So then we use this equation. If it is not, okay, if there is a laminar boundary layer and then turbulent, then we have to go for this equation. So this distinction has to be very clear to you. The set of equations you are going to use, if the flow is totally turbulent and if flow has a laminar and a turbulent, both components. So then the equations used will be different. So keep, please bear in mind, don't forget this, okay? The set of equations will be different, okay? Please keep it in mind, don't forget this, okay? So if it is totally turbulent right from beginning, then we have the equations like this. These are available in the data and book, okay? We'll again show you. We'll go to next, okay, fine. Once we find the Nusselt number, what we do is, we find out the heat transfer coefficient from the Nusselt number. From heat transfer coefficient, we can find out the heat transfer, because heat transfer Q is equal to H into A into delta T. That's the temperature difference between surface and the fluid, okay? So let's go to next slide. If the here we have I have shown the distinctly how equations are different. Suppose if the flow is laminar and turbulent, okay, then the flow will be, first it will have a laminar region, then it will have a turbulent region. This we have seen. So in that case, the thickness of a boundary layer at the, this is called a critical region. Here the flow is transitioning from laminar to turbulent, so this is called a critical region. Thickness here is called a critical thickness. So how to find out this critical thickness? The to find out this, we know that Reynolds number at this critical region is a 5 lakh, okay? So substitute this 5 lakh into the thickness equation and find out the critical thickness, okay? So here I substitute a Reynolds number equal to 5 lakh, okay? X I know, I have found out X, okay? Then I'll get the value for a delta HC, that is the thickness of a boundary layer at critical region, okay? So similarly, the thickness of boundary layer in the turbulent region. So in the turbulent region, here the equation, this equation you have to make use, okay? So this equation is available in the data handbook. I have shown you in the data handbook, this time I show it, okay? So this equation for when the flow is laminar and turbulent, okay? If the flow is only turbulent, right from the leading edge. See, from here, just here it begins, and it, as the flow encounters the surface, there'll be turbulence right from the beginning. Then this thickness is given by delta Hx is equal to 0.381 x into Re to the power minus 2. Okay. So if the Nusselt number, if the flow is laminar and turbulent, then equation is like this. Okay, same Nusselt number, if the flow is turbulent right from beginning, then equation is different. Okay, this is for average Nusselt number for turbulent flow. This is average Nusselt number for a laminar and a turbulent flow. Okay, so please look at these equations, they are different. I will show them once again in the data handbook. Okay, please don't forget that the set of equations that you are going to make use for laminar turbulent flow and just a turbulent flow are different. So once again, we'll go back to the data handbook. So see here, this equation 1.5 is the equation for a laminar turbulent flow for thickness. If it is just turbulent right from beginning, then thickness is determined using the equation, this equation. Okay. If the flow is a turbulent right from the beginning, then the equation for a Nusselt number is given here. This is for a Nusselt number, the Nusselt number at a distance x. Whereas average Nusselt number is given by this equation. This we are going to make use to find out the heat transfer coefficient. Okay. So so please keep in mind that set of equations are different for the laminar turbulent and just turbulent flow. Okay. So now we will solve a problem. Okay. So not on this problem. So there is an air is flowing. Air is flowing at a air at a 20 degree Celsius is flowing at one atmospheric pressure over a flat plate which is 75 millimeter long, and the plate is maintained at 60 degree Celsius. Assuming unit depth, we have to consider unit depth in the x-z direction, that is width of the plate. assume it as 1 meter, calculate the heat transfer from the plate. One. Second one is the find out the boundary layer thickness at the end of plate. So here we have for two conditions we have to do these calculations. First one is assuming turbulence from the leading edge. Right from the leading edge there is a turbulence. Turbulence starts from the leading edge. At the moment flow encounters the plate, turbulence starts. Boundary layer is totally turbulent right from beginning. Assuming that, we have to do one set of calculations. Another set of calculation, assuming that there is a boundary layer, a laminar boundary layer, and later there is a turbulent boundary layer. So for that you have to do another set of calculations. In both the cases, we have to find a heat transfer, that is heat transfer coefficient, and the boundary layer thickness. Okay. So in the problem, what we have to find out? Heat transfer from the plate, thickness of the thermal boundary layer. These things we have to find out. Okay. So to find out the first, let us note what is given in the problem. So what is given in the problem? So let's list the data that is given in the problem. So length of the plate is given, width is given. Length is 75 centimeter, width is 1 meter. Distance from the leading edge, x value is given, that is 0.75 meters, which is equal to length. Okay. Velocity of the flow, fluid velocity is u, which is actually u infinity. Okay. 30. Jaldi udho. But no. U infinity, which is 35 meters per second. Type of fluid is air. Okay. Temperature of the fluid is 60 degrees. Temperature of the wall is 20 degrees. So that means to calculate fluid temperature, we use equation which is average of a fluid temperature and the wall temperature. So therefore, it is Tf is equal to 1 divided by, Tw plus T infinity divided by 2. Okay. So if I do that, 60 plus 20 divided by 2, it will be 40. So fluid filled. Fluid film temperature is 40 degrees Celsius. So we have to find out the fluid properties for this temperature, that is 40 degrees Celsius. Let's go to data handbook. So this in the data handbook properties are, we have to look for a properties of air. Okay. So we have to look for the properties of these values are listed as a properties of gases. So in the page number, it's available in page number 33. Okay. So this is properties of gases, that it begins with the air. Okay. So in this temperature, the film temperature that I have found out is 40 degrees. Okay. So for 40 degree temperature, please read all these values. Density of the fluid. Okay, we need all these values. Density of the fluid, then kinematic viscosity. Kinematic viscosity is 16.96 for 40 degrees into 10 to the power minus 6 here, right? Then we need Prandtl number. So what is the Prandtl number? 0.669. Okay. Then we have the thermal conductivity. Thermal conductivity is 0.022756. Okay. So please note down all these values. Now go back to, so I will read all these values and then so if you see here, I have read the density 1.128 kg per meter cube. Then the kinematic viscosity 16.96 into 10 to the power minus 6. Prandtl number is 0.669. The thermal conductivity, this is 0.027. Okay, it has to be. I'll change that. So then, using these values, I'll find out the Rx, Reynolds number. Okay, what is the Reynolds number? So I find out Reynolds number here. Reynolds number is equal to bulk velocity into thickness length L x is 0.75 divided by kinematic viscosity. I'll get a value of Reynolds number equal to 1.54 into 10^6, which is more than the 5 lakhs. Okay, this is a 15 lakh now. So therefore, flow is a turbulent. That is a sure. So that means the flow has laminar and turbulent both the regions. So then we have to we can find out where this critical transition happens. This transition, where this transition happens, that is called a XC. So where the transition happens is called a XC. The length at which the flow changes from the turbulent to laminar to turbulent is called a XC. This can be found out by, so if you see here, the flow is here initially laminar, then it becomes a turbulent. So this transition, the length at which the flow converts to turbulent, can be determined using this equation. I know that Reynolds number at a transition is 5 lakh, so I substitute that value in this equation. So then XC is equal to Reynolds number, critical Reynolds number, into kinematic viscosity divided by the bulk flow velocity. So if I do that, I get a critical So I'll quickly finish this. Then we are running out of time. Then the remaining part I'll explain in the next session. That will start at 11 o'clock. So please come back at 11 o'clock. We will start this. We'll solve this remaining part of the problem in the next session. We have 10 minutes. Whatever possible, I'll explain now. Okay. So listen here. The flow is laminar from leading edge to a distance of 0.242 meters. Okay. After 0.242 meters, the flow becomes the turbulent. Clear?